We are back, guys, on this Thursday for a new tutorial. And today we're going to talk about displacement map. Contrary to a normal map where the surface is still flat, it's just an illusion, displacement map will actually deform your mesh. You will need a grayscale texture, usually called height map, and a good amount of subdivision. Let me show you. Of course, first you need a displacement map. You can whether find one on a website like Polyheaven and just click on one and download the displacement map here, or you can find one directly using Megascan assets. When you go to Bridge and download one, for example the Mossy Pavers, here you will find three textures. Of course, the diffuse, normal map, and the ORM. You might know this one, and what you might don't know is that you will find a displacement map on the B channel. And this is the one we will use. The second part is to get a model. Here, for example, you can use directly a plane with a good amount of subdivision using modeling tools. So if I go to modeling here, I will create a rectangle here. Just click here and on the left panel, you will enable show wireframe. And here you see, we just have one face. And if you use displacement, you can have just one face. You need a lot of subdivision. So here, for example, I will put in width and depth 50, and I can increase the size of my plane directly here. And if I want, I can increase also my width and depth subdivision one more time. Okay, we're good, we can accept it. Now we have a proper mesh to use. Of course, you can import a plane you made on the other GCC. And if I just drag and drop my texture from Megascan here, here you will see the effects of a normal map. Far away, on a certain angle, it looks like you have a relief. But if you look closer, it's just flat. So here we're gonna use displacement map via modeling tool. So first you apply your texture and then go to modeling, and you will find directly under deform, the displace. By default, it will give you a displacement with a poly noise, but here we want to use the texture that will match the color and all the UV type. So here I'm going to go to my content brother and just click on the ORM, and from there in the displacement type, I will choose texture 2D map. From there, in the options, I will select the ORM map I just selected, and by clicking on the arrow here, it will automatically assign it. And now you have to choose a channel. And with the Megascan assets, you will need to use the blue channel. This is where you have your displacement map. Why? Because if you open the texture and go to the B channel, this is where you can find your displacement. After you choose the correct channel, you will now have the possibility to increase the displacement intensity directly from here. Now you have a correct and real relief. And of course, if you change the UV scale of your texture in first place, you will have to change it here in the UV scale of your displacement map. As I said earlier, when you use displacement map, you will have a lot of polygons. If you go to wireframe mode, you can obviously see that. This is where you can combine, of course, if you want, nanites. By joining your nanites, you will optimize more your scene. And since 5.2, you can find all the displacement methods directly in the edit tab of your mesh. If you select your mesh here, go to Control E for edition. you will now have this little slot of displacement map. So you can use it and go from there directly, but you will not have all the settings you can find in the modeling tool. And that is for today, guys. I hope displacement has no more secrets for you. And see you on next Thursday. Bye.